Welcome to the video news of the week. For over a year now, a committee has been meeting monthly, making plans to celebrate Colebrook's upcoming 250th anniversary. The committee is headed up by David Collins, shown here going over some designs with committee member Mary Ann Woodard Neary for the official emblem of the event, designed by Zach Johnson. This week, plans for the first event of the 250th year were detailed. These will take place on New Year's Day, January 1st, 2020, and include free concerts presented by the Great Northwoods Committee for the Arts at Trinity United Methodist Church. Also, the Colebrook Historical Society, organizers of the celebration, will show historic local films and documentaries at the Tillotson Center. Among the events will include performances by three regional groups. The Eiley Miss Cayley will present Celtic music. Popular local country band Comfort Country will follow. Finally, Kevin Coloso will bring the intriguingly beautiful sound of theremin music to the church. All these events are free and open to the public. Look for more 250th information to come sometime early next year.
On Sunday morning at 9:30 a.m., the Monadnock Congregational Church in Colebrook held a dedication ceremony for the new lift that has been installed in the church. The lift grants access from the ground floor to the second floor sanctuary space. The lift was dedicated in memory to the late Reverend Larry Clough, who passed away in 2015. His wife Sharon and his daughter Lauren were present to cut the ribbon on the access to the lift.
For some of you that don't know Reverend Clough, which I did not know him, he was born on October 22nd, 1933 in Woodsville. He was youngest of five children. He was raised on a farm in Center Haverhill and graduated from the Haverhill Academy. After his academy graduation, he went into the U.S. Navy and served for 4 years, and he was a electronics technician during the Korean War. After his Navy service, he attended Keene State College, where he obtained his teaching degree, and then he taught math at the Stratford Public Schools for over 30 years. And he served as an assistant principal there for many of them. Reverend Clough's faith was an important part of his life, and that's what led him to his ministry. Reverend Clough was the first licensed lay minister in New Hampshire to become ordained, and that happened in 2006. As many of you know, he served as moderator for this church for over 24 years. He was active in the Masons and the Easter Star organizations and had many accomplishments in both organizations.
I've known for years that we've needed something like this to make our church truly handicap accessible. And I've watched a number of people struggle to get upstairs. It's something Larry could have used during the last few years that he was still at home. And so I'm glad, truly happy to say today that that dream has become a reality.
And I might add that Robert's going to be the first one to take the journey up. So, Robert, you want to come forward?
Gee, we should have a little drum roll.
Yeah,
we
should.
He's got a little drum.
Yeah. That's pretty neat.
Yeah. Look for you. Look good for you.
It was a fundraiser, but it was initiated with when Larry passed away. Mm-hmm. That the memorial funds that were giving in his memory were to go towards an elevator. So that was when he passed away in 2015. And it's taken us a while to raise the money to make this happen. But we were successful in raising all the money we needed to pay for it.
Part of the problem is that our congregation has also aged along with the church. And that kind of makes the need for a lift more important.
The lift was done by Dan Hebert Incorporated, and we reached out to the community and to the congregation for support, and we had very good support from both the community as well as the congregation in order to bring this to reality within basically a three-month period. It surprised me how quickly it came together.
Members of the Mohawk Grange visited the Colebrook School on Tuesday afternoon to distribute dictionaries to the third grade students, a tradition of Grangers for the past few years now. The Grangers also took a moment to talk about their organization with the students.
What's your name, right?
started with just farmers as a way to improve their method of being able to get their crops to market. It used to be a secret organization. Grange is all over the United States. Well, one layer of it, we're supporting Grange here locally, Mohawk Grange, which steps up from there to a county Grange, which we call Pomona, to the state Grange. Then we also have a building in Washington, D.C., for the national. We try to do things for the community, this dictionary being one of them, and other things.
The Stratford Grange held a holiday bazaar on Saturday at the lower level of the Stratford Town Hall. Crafts, homemade items, and more were available. Proceeds from the Grange table at the event went to the support of abused or homeless women and children in the area.
I love the
Another edition of the Country Music Appreciation Jam was held at the Burrough Falls Dance Hall last Saturday. The Country Swingers started the day with music at 1 p.m., with many other area musicians performing during the afternoon. Friday's weather brings rain with a high of 40 degrees. Temperatures drop sharply to a high of 32 on Saturday, and Sunday brings snow with a range of 26 to 36 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.